Yes, good morning all.
Morning, sir.
Yesterday, have you solved the problem which I have given as an assignment or a quiz? Yesterday, one problem I have posted in a Google Classroom for a quiz. Have you solved it? Anybody having a doubt in that? Hello. Any students having a doubt in that regard, regarding that question? No, sir.
No, sir.
I'll project the screen. If you have any doubt in any of the word or a sentence in that question, please let me know so that I'll clarify and then proceed further. Can you see the screen? Can you all see the screen?
Yes, sir.
See that a single stage impulse turbine rotor. Single stage means what? It is a D level. Rotor has a diameter. He has given capital D of 1.2 meter per second. Of course, till now we are not solved this type of questions, this type of data in the question class. But it is a basic one. If the diameter of anything and the speed of that is given, you can find out the U. But that means velocity, correct? Because diameter is given, speed of the rotor is given in RPM. Convert that into speed of the convert that into velocity of the rotor. That is U. Velocity of the rotor is U. U is equal to pi d n by 60. Anyway, you are having d, having n divided by 60, you will get converted. That 3000 RPM will be converted to meters per second by pi d n by 60. That is U. You came to know U. Then the nozzle angle is 18 degree. Alpha 1 is 18 degree. Full stop. So you are having a data now with respect to U, with respect to alpha 1. Then the speed ratio is 0.42. What do you mean by the speed ratio? That also we discussed, correct? What do you mean by that speed ratio? Speed ratio is nothing but a phi. Speed ratio is nothing but phi, and the value should be U by V1. So anyhow, you know, speed ratio you know, V1 you can easily find out. So that by that method you can find out V1. So once you know V1, alpha 1 and U, you can complete the inner triangle. You know how to complete it. Done. Here also given, to go for the outlet, something is required. What is required to go for the outlet? Always we want beta 2 as well as VR2. So beta 2 and VR2, where he has given, let me check that. The ratio of relative velocity at outlet to the relative velocity at the inlet is 0.9. That is VR2 divided by VR1 is equal to 0.9, which is called as CB. So from this, we'll come to know the length of VR. Then the outlet angle of the blade is 3 degrees smaller than the inlet angle. That is beta 2 is beta 1 minus 3 degree. That same condition we have taken yesterday. Then, so if you know these two, I can complete the outlet triangle also, correct? Without any second, without any complication, I can complete the second triangle. That is outlet triangle. Then the steam flow rate is 5 kg per second. That is m dot is 5 kg per second. He is asking you to draw the velocity diagram. Of course, you can draw that. And find out the velocity of the virl. What do you mean by velocity of virl? VU1 is inlet virl velocity. VU2 is outlet virl velocity. If I combine those two, it will become velocity of virl or total virl velocity. VU1 plus VU2. If I combine that, we will get total virl velocity. Then axial thrust, AT, that also we had done in the first beginning problem. Then blade angles, that is beta 1 and beta 2. Then power developed, P is equal to m dot into U into VU1 plus VU2 divided by 1000. So all the datas are known. I hope you have completed this. Anybody is having an issue with that? Any student was having an issue with that problem, solving the problem? Ajay Sundil, Ashitesh?
No, sir.
Okay. Have you solved that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, to draw the inlet triangle, remember you, we want u, v1, alpha 1. That's all. To draw the outlet triangle, we want beta 2, vr2. If you know that, we can draw the velocity triangle easily. Okay, Sautrik Rai, are you there?
Yes, sir.
I am seeing you in the class every day, but I am not seeing you in the quiz in time. You are submitting the quiz after the deadline. So attend.
Yes, sir.
Not a zero. Remember, I am telling many times.
Sir, sir, actually, last few days I had my exam, sir. So I came back after giving my exam and I submitted the quiz, sir.
Okay, okay, fine. That we'll see that later. But now, as per the orders, as per the authority's order, they told us to give the attendance based on the attendance of the quiz. So that I considered that. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Later on, you can claim that we are having an exam. You can provide. You can provide a timetable and you can. Climb button, no issue.
Okay.
Any other students having a doubt in the yesterday's problem? I hope no, correct? I hope no student is having a doubt or issue with Chinmay. Chinmay, you asked some question, no, yesterday regarding the speed ratio. Are you there? Chinmay?
Yes, sir.
Yesterday you asked about the formula for speed ratio. Formula for speed ratio is correct. U by V1, what you took is correct. But the formula for U is pi dn by 60, not V. You have taken V is equal to pi dn by 60, correct?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
No, it should not be. Because we always, rotor is rotating means the velocity of the rotor is U, not V1. V1 is the velocity of the jet.
Okay.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Today what we'll do is, we'll go for one more problem. Shall I project a question or shall I dictate a question?
So either is fine, sir.
Okay, okay. I'll project it. Just a minute. Just I'll project it and I'll take back, all of you download it, okay? I'll give the question. In a WhatsApp also I'm sending. Yeah, copy that question. Can you see that?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please copy that. I'll also project. Can you see the screen? One stage of an impulse turbine. One stage means finished. One stage means it is nothing but a D-level turbine. You should know that. One stage is, other name for the one stage is D-level turbine, or a single stage is D-level turbine. Okay. We will go for the next stage in the next, after two classes. I will take you for the next multi-stage. But for time being, you concentrate on single stage only. I hope you have copied the question. Okay. Right? Okay, so I'll start now explaining what he has given. A single stage impulse turbine What do you mean by the single stage? It is nothing but D-level turbine. Is nothing but a single stage. D-level turbine consists of a nozzle of one ring of moving blades. That means it tells that one set. The nozzle is inclined at 22 degree. Alpha 1 is equal to 22 degree. See, all of you, listen to this carefully. Alpha 1 is equal to 22 degree to the tangential speed of the blade. Okay. And the blade tip angles are equiangular. That means beta 1 is equal to beta 2. Equiangular. And are equal to 35 degree. They are equal to 35 degree. Okay, good. Find the blade speed. That means he is asking you to find out U. This is the first question where he is asking you to find out the U without giving diameter and speed of the rotor. That is diameter and N. If you give diameter and N, U will be equal to pi dN by 60. But we will see in this question, he has not given both. Diameter is also not given. Speed is also not given. That means RPM is also not given. So he's asking you to find out U. Okay. Find the blade speed and diagram efficiency. Blade speed is the U and diagram efficiency is nothing but efficiency of blade. This is also equal to efficiency of diagram. I give it in the formula sheet. You can go through. What is the name of blade efficiency and diagram efficiency? Both are same. Okay. By neglecting the losses. By neglecting the losses he has given. What do you mean by that losses? Neglecting the losses. What are all the different losses we'll come across? Can anyone tell? What are all the different losses we'll come across? That means CB is equal to 1. That is the condition given. That means there is no loss. He has simply given no loss. We will assume no loss due to friction. If there is no loss due to friction, what I can write? VR2 will be equal to VR1. This is the condition, correct? Next. If the velocity of the steam at the exit of the nozzle is, that is V1 is equal to 660 meters per second. So these are all the condition given. Any issue, any doubts with the writing the data? Anybody having doubts regarding writing the data?
So again, VR2 equals VR1.
This condition, VR2 is equal to VR1. This is the doubt you are having. So yes. What is the meaning of that is, say for example, I will tell you what all the different losses will come into picture. See, assume that there is a nozzle. See, assume this figure properly. See that figure properly. This is nozzle. Once from the nozzle, the steam will come and it will hit the turbine. Just I'm writing in terms of a square box. That's all. This is turbine. And it will go to generator. Correct? And in between there will be shaft. So these are all the parts which we'll be having for generating a power. So again, there will be a pipe here. This will be pipe. See, if this is the block diagram for steam turbine plant, if this is the block diagram for steam turbine plant, what are all the different losses I can come across? See, here, first loss is this, that is losses due to friction in pipe. Because of the friction, there may be losses. So this is friction in pipe. Let us assume that there is a friction in pipe. One loss will come into picture. And inside the nozzle, I may come across second loss, that is friction in nozzle. This is second loss I can get. Then once it is going out from the nozzle here at the tip of the nozzle, if there is any droplet which is escaping without passing, then this loss also I should consider. This loss is, let us consider that as a third loss, that is losses due to nozzle. Losses at nozzle, this I can consider. Then once it is entering for the turbine, what is the loss I can take out here? Inside the turbine, I can take a loss due to friction. That is fourth loss. Fourth loss is due to friction loss between the blades. And the fifth loss is with respect to the shaft. That is mechanical loss. So many losses I can consider. here in this problem, we are nowhere concerned about the friction in pipe, because no data is given with respect to the pipe, we'll neglect it. No data is given with respect to the nozzle, we'll neglect it. No losses with respect to the leakage in the nozzle are given, we will neglect it also. No losses in the shaft is given, we will neglect the mechanical losses. No losses in generator, we will neglect this. Only we are concentrating on the turbine and the friction within the turbine. Anshit, understood? He is telling all the losses are zero, means there is no loss at all. That means in the friction in the pipe is also zero. Losses due to the nozzle is also zero. Losses due to the exit of the nozzle is also, everything is zero. But if you are not considering all these things, because data what he has given is not supporting to the pipe, nozzle, or the friction, the mechanical losses, they are not supporting. Only the data is supporting with respect to the turbine only. So with respect to the turbine, what will come into picture? Only VR2 and VR1 will come into picture. That means the friction due to the blade. These two are representing the friction on blade surface. Correct? So what I consider out of among so many losses, I am considering only the friction in the blade surface is zero. That means there is no friction, means VR1 will be equal to VR2. If both are equal, VR2 is equal to VR1, then what will be happen? Then what will be the value of CP? CP must be 1, because the formula for CP is equal to VR2 by VR1. If this is 1, then only it will become VR2 is equal to VR1. Understood? Hello? Yes? Okay. Yes, sir. See, so many losses, but of course, in a steam turbine, there will be so many places where the losses will occur. But we are not considering all those places, because here the data given is not supporting to those losses. We will include, as we proceed further and further, we will include the nozzle loss also. I will tell you that. But for time being, the data which is given is not supporting to the nozzle loss or friction in pipe, or mechanical losses. So we will neglect that, and we will concentrate only on the friction occurring, the losses occurring inside the turbine. So the loss occurring inside the turbine is only due to the friction on the surface of the blade, that is corresponding to CB. If CB is 100%, that means 1, then VR2 will be equal to VR1. That is the thing he has given. That's itself, I am assumed that. So how to solve the problem? So first and foremost thing, what to do? I told you to take scale ratio, okay. On what basis you are going to take a scale ratio? I told the length of the U supposed to be 4 centimeters. Maximum it's supposed to be 4 centimeters, or minimum it's supposed to be 3 centimeters. But to take that, in the given question, there is no value of U. U is a question mark, correct? So I cannot take U directly. So what I will do, I will take in other way, that is V1. We are having a value of V1. This is a second thumb rule. The first thumb rule to take the scale ratio is the value of U supposed to be 4 centimeter maximum. Minimum it's supposed to be 3 centimeter. That is first thumb rule to select a scale ratio. The second thumb rule, if U is not given, in some problem we'll come across this cases, U will not be given. So in that case, you take the help of V1. V1 should be always maximum 12 centimeter. Remember, V1 should be always maximum, it is 12 centimeter. So in like that, you take a scale ratio. So if I want to make V1 as 12 centimeter, can you tell what should be the scale ratio? If you want to take V1 as 12 centimeter, what should be the scale ratio? Minimum V1 should be 10 centimeter, maximum should be 12 centimeter. In the textbook, I have taken 11 centimeter. In between that, you can take 10 centimeter also, or 12 centimeter. Don't go beyond those two limits. If you go below 10 centimeter, the velocity triangle will be very, very small. If you go beyond 12, it will be very huge, very big in size. You cannot accommodate in the sheet. So optimum is always better to take in between 10 to 12, or it's better to take 11 centimeter. If you take 11 centimeter, it will be easy for you, it is in this figure. Correct?
So it will be 60 in that case if we take 11.
Okay. If you take 11, then it will be?
1 centimeter equals to 60 meters per second.
1 centimeter is equal to? 1 centimeter is equal to 60
meters per second.
Yeah, this is good, I guess. So because of that only, I have taken the same scale ratio in the textbook, in my textbook. You can take up to 12 centimeter, no issue. This is optimal. Okay, I taken this. So first we know this V1 and we know the scale ratio I came to know now. So what I will do, as you understand this carefully, sorry. What I'll do, because I don't know the value of, I don't know the value of U, but I know it's supposed to be horizontal. So what I'll do, simply I will draw an horizontal line. Can you see that? Can you see in yellow color? This is not required for me. Just I'm drawing a horizontal line. I don't know what is the length I'm taking. Simply I draw a horizontal line. Can you see that yellow color one?
Yes, sir.
No, it's not seen.
I'll make it dark. But now, because value of length of U is not known, so simply I draw a horizontal line. Later on, I'll make it thick. But now, time being, you assume that I drawn imaginary line U horizontal, because you know we know it is U, and from the left hand, the dot what I'm increasing here. From here, if I draw the line, it's supposed to be alpha 1, correct? What is alpha 1? 22. So what I'll do, now alpha 1 is fixed, that I know. Alpha 1 is 22 degree, that I know. So I will make with black color, because I know alpha 1 is
22.
Yes.
Sir, can you use any other color except yellow? Yellow is not very visible on the background.
Because that is not required for me. Further, I want to erase that. It is not possible for me to erase.
Oh, okay.
See, now you understand, just I drawn one horizontal line. Simply, I drawn one horizontal line without maintaining any line. Simply, I drawn one horizontal line. Then, from this point, I know alpha 1 has to come. So, I'm using a black color now. Whichever is mandatory, whichever is I know it has to come from there, I will go with black color. Whichever is not given in the question, but I know it should be horizontal, so I taken yellow color in the line. U for yellow color for U. So what is alpha 1? Alpha 1 should be 22 degree. So take this and draw 22 degree. That is alpha 1 is equal to 22 degree. Why I taken this only in the black color? Because this is given. Alpha 1 is given as 22 degree. I taken this 22 degree. And I know this should be V1. What should be the length of V1 then? As per the scale ratio, the length of
11 centimeters.
Yeah, you make use of a compass, cut an arc. Make use of a compass and cut an arc for 11 centimeter, so that you will end up with this. So, what is the name of this line? The name of this line is V1, and I'll put a arrow mark. See, because length of V1 is also known, angle is also known. I taken in black color, but for you, I don't know the length. It may be so much whatever I drawn, or it may be still more, it may be still less, I don't know where it will come. But I know it should be horizontal, so I take an horizontal. Then, VF1 should be always what? VA1 should be always vertical line, which is dropping down. So that I'm going to drop the vertical line. This vertical line represent VA1. There is no length, just it is a vertical line. Always VA1 is a vertical line. So I will drop VA1. Correct? Then to complete this velocity triangle, what we did, do you remember? To complete this velocity triangle, just we have extended this horizontal line. So this completed. Can you see now? I done in black color. Why I done in black color now? Earlier I taken yellow. Now I am doing black color. Only because I know the length of V1, I know the length of angle of alpha 1, and if I drop VA1, to complete the triangle, just I can complete. That means this point is fixed, this point is fixed, this is fixed. All these three points are fixed. So I can easily draw the triangle. So first triangle I draw. But to draw beta 2, where I should start? To draw beta 2, just I'll change to more. See, to draw beta 2, I can take from here. I don't know from where I'm supposed to take. Because he has not given the value of U. The end of U is not given. But I know the end of U will be somewhere within this. Correct? If you go for the earlier problems, you'll come to know. The length of alpha 2, somewhere, it will be U. I don't know where. It may be here. We have to find out that. So to do that, he has given some exam, some other data. What is that? He has given beta 1 is equal to 35 degree. Beta 1 is equal to 35 degree. That means if I start from here, if I draw 35 degree, it has to connect to this apex. Then only it will become, then that line, whatever the line I'm going to join from this apex to the space equal to 35 degree, wherever it is going to end, that will be the length of u, so that it is impossible to start from here directly. So what I will do, I will take the help of this. Just simply draw an horizontal line. I will take an horizontal line, then from this horizontal line I'll keep a protractor to an angle of 35 degree. I don't know where it will come. From there I will simply extend the line. Understood what I did? So this 35 will be same as this 35, no?
Yes, sir.
That's what I use there. I drawn one horizontal line. From the horizontal line, from the apex, I taken 35 degree. Then I extended the line. And this angle is nothing but beta 1, that is equal to 35 degree. Now I came to know the angle where it is ending. It is ended up to this. So up to this, from here to here, this is called as what? U. So from here to here, this is called as U. Understood how I determine the U? Now I'll make this as black color because this is fixed now. Earlier it was not fixed, now it is fixed. Correct? And the name of this line is VR1. See, many times this question is asked. So many times the same data, same question is asked in exam. If anybody having doubt, you ask me. Shall I proceed? Okay, then we will go for VU1. If you go for VU1, the length of VU1 will be this much. Correct? So inlet triangle is finished. Now we'll go for outlet triangle. To go for outlet triangle, from where I supposed to start? I supposed to start from beta 1. Wherever the beta 1 is ended, here. I supposed to start from here to draw the outlet triangle. That is beta. What is beta 2? Beta 2 is equal to 35, which is equal to beta 1. So I will draw the line and I'll maintain this angle. I will show that angle as beta 2. Outlet, I'll change the different color. This is called as beta 2. That angle is called as beta 2. Now, what should be the length of this? And this naming is, the naming will be, what is the naming of that? I know this is VR2. Now, the second question is, what should be the length of this? What should be the length of VR2? Can anyone tell what should be the length of VR2?
Same as VR1.
Yes, same as VR1, because here in the top, you can see, VR2 is equal to VR1, or you can go for this. CB is equal to 1 because of no loss. So take the same length as VR1. Then, so it will become, I think, probably symmetric with respect to the. Then you draw the drop down the vertical line. This line is called as VA2. Then extend this. So wherever it is ending, connect with this line, and the name of that line is V2. The name of that line is V2. Then this angle is called alpha 2, and the length of this outlet from here to here, it is called as VU. So we got all the data from the triangle. Here only challenging thing is how to get the length of U. How to get the length of U is the challenging thing for you. Once you finish this, as usual, you go for what? Table. You're supposed to go for inlet, outlet, outlet table, inlet table. You divide into three columns. First, in centimeter, meters per second. Here also same way. Centimeters, meters per second. Here you write V1, U, VR1, VA1, VU1, alpha, beta, everything. Similarly here, V2, U, VR2, VA2, VU2, alpha 2, beta 2. You get all these values. I hope you can do this. I'll give you enough time after this. You can do. So you will get all these values for inlet as well as the outlet. Once you get those values, we'll go for unknown. What he is asking you to find out? U. Can you tell U value? U, here also it will be same. Here also it will be same. In centimeter, first you will get in centimeters from the figure, convert that to meters per second. So U will be finished in meters per second. This will be finished. The first unknown will be cleared. What is second unknown? Blade efficiency is asking. What is the formula for blade efficiency? Blade efficiency formula is work done by half into V1 square. Correct? So what is work done? U VU1 plus VU2 divided by half into V1 square. So if you do that, we'll get blade efficiency into 100. If you multiply, you'll get in percentage. Blade efficiency in percentage. Can you try and do that? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Now you take enough time. I'll give now the time is 9:15. No? Now the time is 9:15. Somebody tell me the answer of efficiency. I'll tell the names. I want them to tell the answers. Siddharth R.
Yes, sir.
Rakshit P.
Yes, sir.
Karthikeya.
Yes, sir.
Jitin. Jitin, yeah.
Yes,
I want the answers from you all, so that means others should not do antala. Everybody has to do, but because of time constraints, I am waiting for those four fellows to tell the answers. Others also, if you completed, you can ask. You can tell me the answers. Fast. Yes, anyone get got answer?
Sir, can you explain again how VR2 you took? So since it's like one.
VR2 is equal to VR1. Because CB is equal to 1, no, 100%. There is no loss.
You don't have VR1 value, sir.
VR1 we will get from the velocity triangle, no, first velocity triangle.
Oh, okay, sir. Yeah.
We will get from first velocity triangle.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'll continue the second class also. Then second R. I'll continue the second R.
Sir, plate efficiency is 84.4.
84.4. Yeah, 84.4 is the blade efficiency, correct. Who is that?
Mahima, sir.
Okay, good, good. Others? Any other got the values? So, all of you try to draw to the actual scale.
So I got 82.3% efficiency of blade.
You're drawing by using a plane sheet. No, there may be a chances of error. If you draw by using a graph sheet, you will get exact answer. So exact answer is 84%. Small variations is that, let it be okay, no issue. Okay.
Okay, so
shall I go for the next problem?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Others, I want all others to try to solve the problems. I'll post the question. By that time, please try to solve the problem. Next question is also somewhat tricky. Yeah, I have posted that question in WhatsApp group. Check out. Can you see? You see the question then? Steam flows through a nozzle. Yeah, steam flows through a nozzle with a velocity of 450 meters per second. Okay, that is V1. That you open in the WhatsApp so that I'll write the data. Okay. So what is given? The steam flows through a nozzle with a velocity of 450 meters per second. It means just a minute. So steam flows through a velocity of V1 that is 450 meter per second at an angle of 20 degree. Alpha 1 is 20 degree. It exits the moving blade with a velocity of 100 meters per second. This is very, very important sentence. You underline that. Or you make a note of that. The exit velocity of the blade, the exit velocity of the steam, that means V2. In only this is the problem where he has given V2 directly. V2 is equal to 100 meters per second. So this is important data in this question. No question, the V2 was given. Now he was given the value of V2 directly. VT is equal to 100 meters per second. The exit angle of the steam, alpha 2, is 120 degree with the direction of the blade motion. With direction of blade motion. So this is, these two sentences are very important in this question. I'll stress this while drawing the velocity triangle. Next. Assume the blades are equiangular. Beta 1 is equal to beta 2. The mass flow rate of the steam, m dot, is equal to 7.5 kg per second. Calculate the mean rotor speed. U is equal to how much? Power developed. Power loss due to friction. PF. Power lost due to friction. He's asking this much. Or you can also write this as W dot. This is also equal to W dot F. Okay, this is the notation what I'm going to use. So to start with this, again, whether we know the value of U, whether we know the value of U.
No, sir.
Okay, how to start with this? Can anyone tell? You please tell me so that I'll open the standard velocity triangle. How to start with this?
First alpha 1, sir. 16 degree.
First you draw simply horizontal line. See, in this problem, this is very important. This standard triangle, let it be with me. The standard triangle. So first what I will do, I will try to draw the horizontal line. Why I am changing the color now? Because this horizontal line, I don't know what should be the length of horizontal line. So what I will do, I will try to draw simply a horizontal line. I don't know the length, simply I'll extend, let it be. But I want this end. One end of the horizontal line is important for me. From here, I know V1, I know alpha 1. So first go for scale ratio. What should be the scale ratio? How to take the scale ratio if U is unknown? How to take the scale ratio if the value of U is unknown? Hello?
Yes, sir.
How to take the value of scale ratio if U is unknown? If U is known, you can take 4 centimeter. Like that, you can take a scale ratio. But now, U is unknown. So, how you will take scale ratio? With respect to what? Go for second thumb rule. That is V1. V1 should be maximum 12 centimeter, minimum 10 centimeter. Like that, you take a scale ratio. What is the scale ratio you will take now? And remember, you can take any scale ratio. There is no issue in that. But for manual drawing, if you take in between 10 and 12, it will be good. Only because of that, I told you to take 10 and 12. So can you tell your own scale ratio?
So 1 centimeter equals 40 meters per second.
1 centimeter is equal to 40 meters per second. Hello? Okay. If I take that, let me take 45. If I take 45, then it will be 10, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then it will be okay. No issue. Then we know alpha 1. We know what is the value of alpha 1 and we know what is the value of V1. So draw 10 centimeter line at an angle of alpha 1 is equal to 20 degree. This is V1. So this is finished. Once you know this, we know 10 centimeters is fixed, alpha 1 is fixed. So that this end is also fixed. You drop the vertical line. This line is called VEA1. Then to complete the velocity triangle, draw a horizontal line and complete it. VA1 is also completed. This is the direction for this. Then if I measure, from here to here, what is the notation I supposed to get? That is VA to VF. If I measure, the notation will be VU1, correct? If I measure from this alpha to VF, VA, the notation I'll get, the distance between those two is VU1, that you already know. So how to get U? I may start U here. I may get U here, I don't know, but I know it should be a horizontal line. How to get this? Can anyone tell?
So we need beta for it.
We did beta. Beta 2 is not given. No, beta 1 and beta 2 values are not given. So I cannot take the value of beta 1 and beta 2. If beta 2 is given, sorry, beta 1 is given. Earlier what we did, we had taken horizontal line, this line, and then we have proceeded. But now I cannot do that. I cannot do that because beta 2, beta 1 is not given. So what I will do, for this problem, I will take the help of outlet. So outlet, if I draw the line from here to other side, here, what is the line I supposed to draw? Can you tell? You go for the original figure. See here. Now we are having horizontal line, we are having vertical, and this is completed. Now I will start from here because beta 1 and beta 2 is good. No, we'll not start from here. I'll start from here. If I start from here and if I draw the line, what is the name of the line?
So V2.
V2. I will draw V2 at an angle of alpha 2. See, the alpha 2 is, the value of alpha 2 is less than 90 degree here. But in this question, here, in this question, alpha 2 is equal to 120 degree with the direction of blade motion. That means what? See, now I'll draw the line. I will draw one line here. The angle, I will draw one line. Okay, I draw the line. And this angle supposed to be, he has not given this angle. What he has given? He has given the other angle. This angle he has given. That is alpha 2 dash is equal to 120 degree. Can you know? Can you tell how I taken this as alpha 2? On what basis I taken this as alpha 2 dash? On what basis I taken alpha 2 dash? Because I know the blade is moving in this direction. That is U is moving from right to left. So he has given, in the question you can see, 120 degree with the direction of blade motion. That means from here it is 120 degree. From here to here it is 120 degree. So that, what is exact alpha 2 value? So this is not alpha 2. This is alpha 2 dash. Understood how we got this alpha 2 dash?
Yes, sir.
Therefore, alpha 2 is equal to how much? 180 degree minus alpha 2 dash. So it will be 60 degree. So take 60. This is alpha 2 is equal to 60 degree. And what is the length of this line? We know it's supposed to be V2. What should be the length of that V2?
So 2.2 centimeter.
Yes, 2.2 centimeter. You try to draw 2.2 centimeter. So once you fix this, I can draw the vertical line. I can draw the vertical line, and this vertical line will be equal to VA2. And I'll finish this. If I measure the distance from, if I measure the distance from this point, that is VA2 to alpha, what is the name of this line? Can you tell? VU2. So partially the figure is completed. Now only left out thing is beta 2 and beta 1. How to find out beta 2 and beta 1? So what I will do to get that, have you completed till here? All of you complete till here. I will go to explain beta 2 and beta 1, how to find out. First, you all of you complete till here. I'll write a note also for your understanding. What is the note for this problem? Hence, beta 1, comma beta 2, comma u is not given. And v1 alpha 2 is given. We will finish to draw V2. We will finish to draw V2 and alpha 2 first, rather than beta 2 and VR2. So in the earlier problem, do you remember we are starting with beta 2 and VR2? But here beta 2 is also not given, VR2 is not given. So we will, he has given other way, that is V2 and alpha 2. So we will start from V2 and alpha 2 rather than beta 2 and VR2. So all of you write a note and then be complete till here and let me know. Guda Jayant Reddy. Are you there? Darshan?
Sir.
Yeah, okay. Complete it and please let me know. Once it is completed, let me know. Darshan?
Yes, sir.
Complete it and let me know.
Okay, sir.
Finished till there. See, this is graphical method. You have to involve and you have to solve.
So can you project the screen?
Yeah, yeah. Done. Tarun Pachauri.
Done, sir.
Okay. Shall I proceed further?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. See now. Now, to go for this, to find the length of this U, what I will do? Now I am having this vertical line and this triangle I'm having. Just I will do the replica, I means I will do the mirror image of this. So how to do that? See, whatever the length of VA is there, whatever the length of VA, I will start whatever the length of VA, that VA, same length I will drop down below vertically. Just a minute. We don't know, it's not working. Dice Lab is not working. Just I'll open the software. I'll open the software and draw it. Okay. I'll open the SolidEd software. See now, what we did, I had taken on simply horizontal line. I don't know from where to where I should supposed to take. Simply I had taken. Then from here, I had drawn the angle of how much?
20 degrees.
Yeah, 20 degrees. Then the length supposed to be equal to this length I had taken as per the scale, how much it was?
10 centimeters.
10 centimeter, no? 10 centimeter, I taken. Then I just dropped this vertical line. Then I completed this triangle. Till here, this is nothing but inlet triangle. Then to go for the outlet, what I did, I taken the help of this and simply I drawn. And what is the angle of this? This is supposed to be 60 degrees. That is also fixed. And what should be the length I supposed to take as per the scale ratio? How much you have taken?
Sir, 2.22
centimeters. It's 2.22 centimeters.
22.22 centimeters. Okay. This is a centimeter and the angle we have taken. I'll delete this. Okay. Understood, no? The angle length and how we take, how we took that. To complete this, simply I dropped the vertical line. I completed this. So this is alpha and all. You write on that later because I cannot write alpha and all here comfortably. Next, to finish this figure, what I will do, I will take the outlet and I will do the mirror image. I will do the mirror of that. Clear? What it did? Same figure I have mirrored. Whatever there is there, the outlet portion, I have mirrored it with the horizontal line. Then from this end, from this apex, simply I have connected to the inlet. Wherever it is passing. So this one I'll show you to the different colors so that it will be easy for you to understand. Those three. See what I did. Whatever the length is there, I have mirrored it. And whatever is there, this, I have mirrored this. Then I have completed this line. If you want, you can eliminate this line to mirror. Only you can mirror this vertical line. Whatever the vertical line is there, just to mirror it. Wherever it is going to end, from there you take the line and connect to this point. So the line, the portion of the line from here to here, that is called as VR2, and this angle is beta2. sorry, beta 1, that is beta 1. And to complete the triangle, if I do this, this completes the triangle and this angle is beta 2. 27. Can you see? Beta 1 is equal to beta 2. It has satisfied automatically. See, this is beta 2 and this is beta 1. Both are satisfied. Can I explain once again? Shall I explain once again or you understood?
Understood.
Okay. So from this, you will get all the values. See here, V1 is this, VR1 is this, VA1 is this, VU1, U also you got. Similarly, outlet also you got everything and try to finish the calculation.
Sir, VR1 is 7.4, sir.
No, you are telling in terms of centimeter. You tell in terms of meter per second. So what he is asking? Over developer P. Capital P, that is also called as W dot. I cannot write W dot, so I'll fix up to P only here. P is equal to M dot, also I cannot write M into U into V U 1 plus V U 2. Close the bracket. Divided by 1000. To do this, you will get in terms of kilowatts. Next, he has given power loss due to friction, PF, or you can also take as W dot F. The formula will be M dot inside the bracket VR1 my VR1 square. I don't know how to put that. VR1 square. Can understand that it is a square? Or shall I project this formula sheet? That will be better, I guess. Wait, I'll project the formula sheet. Because that is not working. I don't know why. Check that later. Wait, I'll project the formula sheet. I hope in the classwork I given no formula. Yes. See here. Power loss due to friction, PF, or W dot F is equal to M dot VR1 square minus VR2 square by 2 into 1000. If you do that, you'll get in kilowatts. Can you tell what is power loss due to friction?
So which is the mean rotor speed?
Mean rotor speed is U. U is the mean rotor speed. Because U1 is inlet rotor speed, U2 is exit rotor speed. If it is U, it is mean rotor speed. Here there is no question of U1 and U2. Whatever the U you are getting, that itself is mean rotor speed.
Okay, sir.
Finished? Kartikeya, mute, no? Others, please tell me the answer. If you want formula sheet, I'll project that. Power developed is this P or W dot. Capital W dot is also called as P. This is power developed. Here I have put here plus or minus symbol. What is the reason I put, included the plus or minus symbol? That depend upon the velocity triangle. If the VU2 value is inside, you take minus. If the VU2 value is outside, you take plus one. Finish it fast. I'll do one more problem and then I'll wind up today's class. Next question also I have posted in a group. So I'll delete the first two questions. This question also I'll delete. But before deleting, you please copy that question or download it. Anyone completed? Whether you have any doubts or not, if you have any doubts, please let me know. I'll explain that once again.
Just 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm. If any doubts, I'll clarify. Hello. Done.
So is the power developed 38,863 kilowatt?
Power developed is power output. I got 427.5.
Oh, okay, yes. I got very high values. I'll check
others?
It out.
Others?
Sir, I got 197.74 kilonewton.
No. Check out.
So I got 400 kilowatt.
Okay, that is fine.
2.7, sir.
No, I don't know how.
Can you say the formula for power developed again?
Power developed, huh?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, P is equal to m dot VU1 plus VU2 into U divided by 1000 kilowatts.
1 minute,
sir. M dot is 7.5. What is VU1 plus VU2? Anyway, I've drawn the actual scale now. I can measure here only. So this is nothing but VU1 plus VU2. This is U. Convert to scale ratio. This is U. U is equal to 26.72 centimeter. And VU1 plus VU2 is equal to 105.08 centimeter. Convert that to meter per second. Only these two are required to get the power developed or power loss due to friction. Okay, power loss due to friction, we want VR1 and VR2. I'll draw that.
So 26 centimeters U value.
Yeah, it's 2.6 centimeters.
2.6 centimeters.
Sorry.
Sir, I got 2.9 centimeters. Is that okay?
Okay, but check out, okay, 2.6, and this is 10,
10.2.
Okay, that is okay, 10.2 is okay. VR1 and VR2, that also I'll write.
VR1, I got 7.4, VR2.
VR1 is equal to, I'll write in centimeter, 7.44 centimeter, VR2 is equal to 4.24 centimeter. So these four datas are enough to draw to get the power output. See, everybody, if you got the same answer, scale ratio you convert. I hope there will be no issue, no? If you convert into scale ratio.
I'm getting the same 402.77
power. But then why, what is the issue? 402 is correct.
That's what I said the last time also.
Okay. Earlier somebody told some other answer, no? What is the scale ratio if you convert, how much it will be? What will be the scale ratio here if you convert?
One one seven meters per second.
And what
that's
about
U value, no, sir?
Yeah, U. What about VU1 plus VU2, combination of those two?
472.5.
Is equal to 472.5 meters per second. Use this and get the value of. Okay, I will tell the answers what I got. Okay, you go through that. Power developed is 427.5 kilowatts. I'll write the answers what I got. You write, you find out. P is equal to 427.5 kilowatts. And power loss due to friction, PF, capital PF, is equal to, I got 298.13 kilowatts. You go through that. Clear? If I'm having any issue, we'll see. Because that is not working, iScribe is not working. I cannot write properly in this solvage. Is that fine? Shall I proceed further? Okay, I'll project the next question. I'll project the next question. All of you copy that question. See here. That I have posted in the WhatsApp group also. In a single stage impulse steam turbine, in a single stage impulse steam turbine, the mean rot, the mean diameter of the blades is 1 meter. And one more thing I want to tell you. Today's quiz, I won't give any quiz. I will give a blank space and I'll ask you to upload whatever you have done today. Whatever you have done today in the class, regular class, three problems. Those three problems you're supposed to upload in the Google Classroom. That is the quiz for today's class. Okay? You have to draw anyhow. No time is required because everything is done in the classroom, you know. Draw to the actual scale. Upload that in the Google Classroom. I will give enough time today. Is it clear?
Hello.
No quiz today. Today, anyhow, everything you have done. So the, whatever the answer you got, that itself I'll consider as a quiz questions and I'll give the marks. So everybody has to upload your own diagrams by writing your names, USN at the bottom, put your signature for all the sheets. And write the sheet number 1, 2, 3, 4. So that will be easy for me to trace where you are done, where you left out. Okay, write down. In a single stage impulse turbine, the main rotor blade is 1 meter. He has given diameter is 1 meter. It runs at 3000 RPM. If you know D and N, you convert U. You can do that easily. Next. The steam is supplied from the nozzle at a velocity of 350 meter per second. And the nozzle angle is 20 degree. The rotor bleed are equiangular. The blade friction factor is 0.86. That is CB. Draw the velocity diagram and calculate the power developed if the actual thrust is R. Here in this question, this is the new data, new thing what you're going to learn. If the axial thrust is 117.72 Newton, how to do that? We'll do. I'll explain how to do that. First, I'll write down the data. Okay. What I'll write the data. What are the data given? He has given us single stage turbine. So that is D level. And the diameter of the blade, D is equal to 1 meter. Concept, N is equal to 3000 RPM. Next, the steam supply from the nozzle, V1 is equal to 350 meters per second. The nozzle angle, alpha 1. Alpha 1 is 20 degree. Next, what he has given? The rotor blades are equiangular. Beta 1 is equal to beta 2. Beta 1 is equal to beta 2, right? Beta 1 is equal to beta 2 because of equiangular. And he is asking you to find out the CB, friction factor. CB is equal to 0.86. Calculate the power developed, P, that is also equal to W dot, capital W dot in the top. Please ask how much? Kirana. Next, the axial thrust. AT, Kirana. AT is equal to 117.72 Newton. So these are all the data given, correct? axial thrust, what is the notation I explained? We will see here. Axial thrust is equal to AT or FA. We'll take both. Or it is also called as FA. So axial thrust is also called as FA. So these are all the data given. So here again, U is not given. So we will go for U is equal to pi d n whole divided by 60. So if you do that, how much you'll be getting? So can you calculate and tell how much you'll get?
151.07.
157.07.
08 meters per second. So the U is finished. If U is known, then the U, V1 and alpha 1. If it is known, then the solution will be easy. What is U? 157.08. V1 is 35, 350 and 20. So that I will write the scale ratio. What is the scale ratio you're supposed to write? What is the scale ratio? Scale ratio will be equal to 1 centimeter will be equal to how much? Check out the U. U should be 4 centimeters. So that how much I can take?
39.2 centimeters.
39.2. In that case, you take 40. 40 meters per second. So instead of taking decimals, you take the whole number. 1 centimeter is equal to 40 meter per second. Next. I will go for this. I will draw the diagram. Just a minute. Okay. What is U as per the scale ratio? What should be the length of U as per the scale ratio? Can anyone tell? See, the scale ratio is 40. U is 157. So what should be the scale ratio? Around?
Around 4, sir.
4, eh? Okay. I will take 4 centimeter. So this one, you try to draw. Okay, whatever. You try to draw to the actual scale, 4 centimeters. Okay, done. V1 is given, alpha 1 is given. As per the scale, what is V1 and alpha 1? Sorry, alpha 1 is how much? 20 degree. So I know it's supposed to be 20 degree. So I will make this as 20 degree. And what should be the length? What should be the length here?
8.75.
Yeah, you can cut an arc or you might make this as 87.5 centimeters. Next. So instead of this dimension is required for calculation for others. What you write as V1. I'll write here as V1 and this is U. But you don't write the dimensions in the notebook, just for understanding purpose, I'm given here. This is V1 and this is U. Then once you know this, drop the vertical line. This is as usual. Complete this. So that we will get beta 1 is equal to beta. Beta 1 is 35. And here, this is VR1. And here, this is VA1. And this length. From here to here, this called 82 point something, and the name for that is, what is the name for this? VU1, virl velocity at the inlet. So we've cleared all the values in the inlet. This is no issue. So coming for the outlet, he has given beta 1 is equal to beta 2. So directly you can go for beta 1 is equal to beta 2, that is 35 degree. You maintain that angle as 35 degree. Finished. What should be the length of this? I'll delete this length. Okay. What should be the length of this? It should be equal to CB. Okay. I'll calculate here. Okay. VR2 divided by VR1, that is equal to how much? 0.86. So that 0.86. So that what is VR2? Sorry, VR1. VR1 is here. See, 51 point, 5.175 centimeter. Convert that to scale ratio. So from figure, I'll write here. From figure, VR1 is equal to 5.175 centimeter. And it is equal to how much meter per second? Convert that to scale ratio. 5.175 into 40. That is 207 meters per second. So as per the scale ratio. So here you draw the line which is equal to 207. Sorry, how much is supposed to be? Sorry, VR1 is okay. What is VR2 then? If this is the case, what is VR2? VR2 is equal to how much?
178.02.
Yeah, how much it is?
178.02
meters per second. And that is equal to how much centimeters?
Four point four five centimeters.
So that here I will draw that much length. Yes, here this is important. Again, here in this triangle, I'll delete these angles and all. I draw this angle equal to 35 and this equal to 4.45. And what is the name of this? The name of this line is equal to VR2. Anybody having doubt? So in this figure, if I drop this, can you see? If I drop this, what is happening? The name of this dropped line is called VA2. The value of VA2 came inside. It did not went outside. And if I draw this line and connect this to make a triangle, this is equal to V2. So where is alpha 2 then? Alpha 2 will be equal to this is alpha 2, 98 degree. Then where is VU2? VU2 will be this much. Here VU2 is, all of you got the same thing?
Yes, sir.
It went inside. So many cases, figures will go inside. In that case, what to do, you should know. See, this is VU2. I'll write here. VU2. So we'll consider this VU2 as negative. If it went inside, wherever VU2 is supposed to be submitted, we're supposed to submit it in negative symbol. That's all. Okay, done. So here, for this figure, so that what is VU1, VU2, then VU. VU for this it will be equal to VU1 minus VU2. That means wherever we are substituting VU, or this is equal to total virl velocity. Total virl velocity is equal to VU, and that is equal to VU1 minus VU2 because it went inside the triangle. VU2 went inside. What is VU1? VU1 will be equal to 8.22 centimeter. Convert that to meter per second. And VU2 is equal to how much? Check here. VU2 is equal to 3 point, VU2 is equal to we got 0.352 centimeters. Tell me the answers. So this is 14.08 meters per second. And here it is. You can directly put as negative value only here. Or that's left to you. How you will take that formula? 3.22 into 40. So this is equal to 328.8 meters per second. So that I got V1, V2, and total viral velocity. Total viral velocity, how much you got? VU is equal to, what is V1? 328.8 minus of 14.08. So that is equal to VU. That is equal to how much?
314.72.
Meters per second. So this is what we got, total VU. See, you should know one way supposed to put this negative symbol. This is very, very important stuff. This is called total viral velocity. So what he is asking in this question now? We'll go for the question. What he is asking? He is asking to find out beta 1 and beta 2 is finished, no? Beta 1, beta 2, how much we got? Yeah, 35 here. Here also it's supposed to be 35 because we have taken the same value, 35. So first unknown is cleared. Second unknown is P, power developed. So what is the formula for power developed? I'll project that also. Formula for power developed, P is equal to M dot U V1. Whether I should put plus or minus here for this problem?
Minus.
Yes, V1 minus V2, that's all. Or total viral velocity I found out, no? M dot U total viral velocity. VU1 minus VU2 already done. So that you can put M dot U total VU divided by 1000. That also you can do. So what is unknown in this equation? To do that, U I can take from the triangle. VU1 I can take from triangle. VU2 I can take from triangle. Yeah, unknown is what? M dot is unknown. So to go for M dot, he has given some other data. What is that data he has given? Axial thrust. So where is axial thrust? Yeah, here is axial thrust. Axial thrust is equal to M dot VA1 minus VA2. You know axial thrust? VA1 I can take from figure, VA2 I can take from figure. M dot I can find out from this equation. So let us find out M dot. First, let us find out M dot. That is axial thrust that is equal to FA is equal to M dot multiplied by VA1 minus VA2. So this is the formula for this. From this equation, what I'll take out? M dot is equal to this module. M dot is equal to FA divided by VA1 minus VA2. So we will get M dot. How much you got? Can anybody tell? Shall I project VA1 and VA2 values? Now all these values are not required for me. So what I'll do? I'll delete this. Whichever is not required, I'll delete now.
2.9 centimeter VA1.
Okay. So I'll project and check out. So this is VA2. This is VA1. VA1. You can see here 2.993, 25.4. So that is FA is equal to how much? 117.72 divided by per meter per second. You have to convert into meter per second. This 29.93.
116.
Converted?
Yes, sir. 116 meter per second.
116 minus second. Others? Other side? VA 2.5. 2.5, yeah?
Yes, sir.
2.5, yeah? Centimeters, okay. But what about?
Yes, sir. 1 minute.
VA1 is equal to 29.2993 centimeter. That is equal to 1119.72 meters per second. Analog policy following up. Okay, because I'm taking third decimal, so I got this value. You whatever the value you got, you put. I'll write the values what I got there. 7.2 because of third decimal. That's all.
7.2. Because I'm using a m dot value. Sir.
96. So if you do this, 119.72 minus of answer.
M dot is 6.63. So
just a minute, I'll check out 117.72. So I got 6.62. Okay, dot correct. No issue. That is
7.35 is.
Yeah, I know. You will get that much answer. What is the reason? Because here, while taking centimeters, I taken third decimals, up to third decimals, because I'm doing in a software, no?
Okay, sir.
Software will give up to third decimals or fourth, nth number of decimals it can give. So I taken. You can calculate only with the manual drawing 2.5. That's all. Or maximum, you can go for 2.55. You cannot get exact value. Because of that, this has happened. No issue. Anyhow, 8% error is acceptable, no?
Okay.
So once m dot is finished, you go for p. Capital P is equal to how much? M into u into vu1 minus vu2 in this case. Vu2 whole divided by 1000. How much you got? E is equal to m dot you got above, that is 6.63. I'll write the values what I got as per my scale. Okay, you write down your scale.
327.8 kilowatts.
Already done.
No, power developed.
Yeah, 328. Huh? 3. How much you got? Whether u is given, u we got now 157. 157.08. Is u that multiplied by vu1 minus vu2. Vu1 is somewhere we got 328.8 minus 14.08. Close the bracket. Oh, n divided by 1000. So if you do this, we'll get power developed in kilowatts. I'll do that. I'll calculate and write all the answers. Whatever I got, I'll write. Okay. 328.8 minus of 14.08 multiplied by 157.08 multiplied by 6.638 divided by 1000. So I got 328.15 kilowatts. So this is the answer.
3.72 I got. Is that wrong?
Yeah, because that is because of the decimals. Here, yes. I only showed you, no?
Yes, sir. So is it
acceptable, sir? Yes, acceptable. No issue. See here, for this case, they'll give the more marks for drawing.
Okay.
And the procedure what you are following.
Okay.
So these are all the answers for this. This U is also. Here you got? All of you got this. How to solve?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is the method where you're supposed to follow for the steam turbine problems. Only thing what is my intention is to show you is this. If it went inside, when the value of VU2 will be negative and when the value of VU1 will be positive, VU2 will be positive. You can do this method or you can also write down because of that negative, because of went inside, here only you can put negative value. Minus VU2 we got. Therefore, always use this as positive value. Positive, like this you can put. This is also okay. VU2, why, what, it went inside, so I got negative. That you should know. Directly you can put negative symbol here or I can put positive, this line. This and this. Because of this. So these three lines. Okay now, any doubts? Hello? Shall I wind up the class? Shall I wind the class now? So before logging out, what you do is I'll give the permission now. All of you type your USN number and name. Type your USN number, just USN number. Name I can catch, I can take that. Type your USN number, you can leave the class. And submit today's class, whatever you have done in a separate sheet in PDF file. Write your name, USN, put your signature for all the sheets. Write the sheet number and then submit in a Google Classroom. I will provide the space as a quiz only. As a quiz only, I'll provide, then only you upload.
Thank you, sir.